Hey guys, how are you? Jeff Gellman, solid canine training, and we're going to be showing you a video of this dog Peanut that just came in, and you're going to see the intake, you're going to see, listen to the owners, their struggles, you're going to see, I'm going to explain in detail what I did to stop it, literally within the first 3 to 5 minutes of the intake. You're going to see then Angelo walk up to the dog, dogs walk up to the dog. You're going to see the dog in front of a TV not barking. You're going to see day two of Courtney working the dog. And this all happened. This dog is 9 years old, a lot of practice unwanted behaviors. And you're going to see how effective applying a proper punisher is. A lot of people, what they do is they don't feel that you should apply a proper punisher to build a relationship with the dog. I highly disagree with that. Why would I want to deal with the nonsense of the dog when out of one to three seconds, I can stop a behavior? Just keep in mind there's 86,400 seconds in a day. 1 to 3 seconds to tell that dog to cut out the nonsense so we can actually work. Then the relationship can be built. But I don't want to have to deal with all the nonsense. So we've done this thousands of times. It works. It doesn't make the dog worse. All the stuff you're hearing on social media, how, oh, applying a correction, you know, makes things worse, or you should build a relationship with the dog first, then correct it. It's a falsehood. It's a lie. You saw the dog at the intake. You saw the dog on day one. You saw the dog on day two. You tell me if that dog's in a better headspace. That's it. So watch the video. Look at the video, listen to the narrative, the audio narrative, the written narrative, understand what the owner's pain points are. This is a dog that barks at everything that moves, dogs and humans. This is a dog that bites people. This is a dog that they cannot take anywhere. And now you're seeing a dog that actually is workable in one day. We do it all the time. That's why I preach. That's why I get on my soapbox. That's why I yell and scream. That's why everybody needs to learn how to apply a proper punisher, correction. All it is a bad behavior stopper. That's it. And then we can work the dog. And now we've got 3.6 million seconds, because that's how long the boarding train is, to teach that dog all kinds of great stuff. Pay attention. Watch. It's a lot of fun. We've done this thousands of times. We're in the trenches doing the work. Jeff Gellman, I'm madly in love with you. Enjoy the video. Ask your questions below. All right? Love you guys. Bye.
Yeah, he's gone.
All right?
Stop.
Another person, no wonder he's outraged.
So he does that with people or dogs or both?
People in the door.
So he bites people when they're walking away, so they're leaving the house.
Or just
walking in general, even on the street.
Or
okay.
If he's crowded.
It can be images on television.
That's annoying.
Like dog images.
Especially dog images.
It started with dog images, and now it is progressed.
No, he hits all the animals.
Any animal and any fighting.
Dog images. Hey guys, how are you? Jeff Gellman, solid canine training with another episode of Man in the Arena. And this is where I will give you in detail, step by step, how we work with a dog. And everything I say, everything I preach, we document on video, we put into practice here. And why? Because it works. And so many families are out there struggling with their dogs. Frankly, I don't want you to struggle with your dog. So we had a dog came in yesterday, Peanut, and you'll have seen the video right before this video of Peanut's behavior. He's 9 years old. A lot of learned bad behaviors. He barks at everything that moves. Every human, every dog. You watch the video, we could not even have a conversation with the owner. He was out of control. So the owners left. I did two protocols the first thing. Number one, he was barking like crazy. Number two, he was trying to break out of his crate. Right now, he's calmly in his crate. okay? It's day one of training. The philosophy, though, is you have to stop the unwanted behavior, the dangerous behavior. So what the first thing I did was what? We have to neutralize, we have to do triage. We've got to get the dog to stop the barking, and then also he was trying to get out of his crate. Tries to bust out of his crate, he was biting the crate. So the first thing I did when I grabbed the leash and he was barking at everything around here that moved, I said no, and I bonked him. If you don't know what a bonker is, a bonker, this is the bonker we use on this dog. There's all different size bonkers. So I've got a video on how to make a bonker, how to use a bonker, and the timing of the bonker. So with this dog, I said no, and then I deployed the bonker. The dog is in a state of barking to the point of being drunk on the sidewalk that can't be reasoned with. Many, many years of practiced bad behaviors. You cannot walk this dog down the street. You cannot bring this dog anywhere. You cannot have this dog in your home without it barking at everything that moves. So step one, knock it off. Enough of the barking. The dog hasn't barked since, by the way. Number two, we put the dog in the crate. We did crate drills. In the crate, out of the crate. 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 We have a very specific way on how we kennel up dogs. We have free videos on that. We don't want them to rush out. We don't want them to rush in. Training starts. Now, once he was in the crate, he started biting the crate, scratching at the crate. Dog can ruin its teeth. Dog could break a nail. Dog could damage a crate. What do? Well, we had a remote collar on him. He's using a Dog Tri Mini Educator IQ, which are very small remote collars. And what do you do when a dog is trying to get out of a crate? You make it uncomfortable to do so. Why? Because a dog can harm itself. It also has the dog in a panic mode. A lot of you have heard you shouldn't use a remote collar on a dog in a crate because it'll have a negative association with a crate. A little bit of information for all the folks out there. I don't go up to dogs and correct them in crates for behaving. So the behavior already exists. The behavior was there prior to me working with the dog. Well, I heard it makes it worse. For some weird reason, after 10,000 dogs, a lot of crating up, I've never seen it make it worse. I've only seen the problem eliminated. Over and over and over again, that's all we see. We see a dog that didn't like the crate, now shut up in the crate. So now, when I take the dog out, break. Good job, buddy. We can start the work. Like, that's just day one. That whole protocol took 1 second to bonk, 3 seconds to remote collar. There's 86,400 seconds in a day. Yesterday there was 86,400 seconds. I spent 4 of those seconds telling this dog no. 4 seconds. So now when we have a dog approach and he sees the dog, he minds his business. Angelo, come here. Walk up to me. And we have a kid approach. Fist bump. Bam. Kick the ball towards me. One hell of a kick there, kid. What could he do?
It's because I'm wearing slippers. I don't want to hurt my toes.
Okay. One pass over to Gretchen's jacket. It's the blue jacket, whoever's jacket that is. Okay. All right. So, now we have a dog that we can start working with. Now we can do all the reward stuff.
Very good.
and the dog understands the concept of no. That was established in the first 30 minutes, and it took 4 seconds. 9 years old dog, you saw the video, that was eliminated. These are the facts. A lot of people will say, well, he's just repressing it and it's all gonna come out. Bad behaviors can start at any time. For some weird reason, we're not seeing that. It's called imagined harm. People assume it could come out, but for some weird reason, we don't see that. All we see is dogs getting better and better and better. One of the things that we talk about is applying a punisher. Punisher is not abuse. If you've been hearing in the background, you've been hearing a clicker. Why? Because we clicker train every dog that comes in here, and we use food. So, because we're training them to do things, but we want to stop them from doing things, what do? You have to learn how to apply a punisher. I've been talking about that for 15 years. In 2021, I'm going to be getting into very exact detail on how to do that, because that is how you stop an unwanted behavior. And now we've got a dog that can start being worked with. The dog was out of control yesterday. Today, we have a nice, quiet dog. So you can decide for yourself. And we're just beginning. We've got 6 weeks, 3.6 million seconds left of his boarding training. We're gonna accomplish a lot. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. I'm in the trenches, I'm in the arena. This is what we do every day. Love you madly, bye.